sorry.
I'm hit.
I'm blind.
Buffy.
I knew this day would come. Still, she had to go sometime.
I met this girl when I was travelling, whose dad had to go to war, but he was crippled. And so because she wasn't what her parents wanted, I mean, not that Amber wasn't what you wanted, but, you know, she was different, like a tomboy. So she stole her dad's armour and went to war instead of him, and then they won the war because of her.
That's Mulan.
Mulan, yes, that's her name. Do you know her?
It's a Disney film.
It's a Disney film, yes. Yeah, and there's a song in it, which is about how she wants to look in a mirror and then seeing her real reflection. I think that's probably a bit how Amber's feeling.
Like Mulan?
Yeah.
Eddie Murphy does the voice of the dragon. Certainly, to my mind, his third best film.
Does anyone want a drink?
A bit early for that, isn't it? Yeah, go on then.
I was thinking more like a tea. Are you worried about Amber?
Nah. She got three languages and a Dutch cap, she'll be fine. Cheers.
You are so blind. You so do not understand. You weren't there at the beginning. You don't know how good it was, how important. This is it for you, this jumped-up firework display of a toy advert. People like you make me sick. What's wrong with you? Now, I don't care if you've saved up all your 50p's, OK? Take your pocket money and get out!
What a prick.
Tim, can I have a word with you in my office?
Yes.
Have a seat, Tim. Twiglet?
I better not.
I was like you once. Blonde hair, scraggy little beard, childlike ears, full of beans and spunk. I let my principles get in the way sometimes. I punched a bloke in the face once for saying Hawk the Slayer was rubbish.
Good for you.
Yeah, thanks. But that's not the point, Tim. The point is, I was defending the fantasy genre with terminal intensity when what I should have said is, Dad, you're right. But let's give Krull a try and we'll discuss it later. The Phantom Menace was 18 months ago, Tim.
I know, Bilbo. Okay, it still hurts. You know, that kid wanted a Jar Jar doll.
Kids like Jar Jar.
Why?
What about the Ewoks, hey? They were rubbish. You don't complain about them.
Yeah, but Jar Jar Binks makes the Ewoks look like fucking Shaft.
I've had enough, Tim.
But Bilbo...
Look, I know how you feel, right? I really do. But this can't go on.
What are you trying to say, Bilbo?
I'm going to have to let you go.
Phew! I thought you were going to fire me then. I was like, phew. Look at that.
Right, Daisy. Off to work. Should be back in a couple of hours.
Okay. Mike, have you got any money?
Oh, if you mean actual currency, no.
I'm sure that I had some, but just seems to have just gone.
Oh, I should, you know, get off.
You didn't sort of borrow it? You know, kind of just go through my pockets and...
Steal it?
God, I'm sorry. God, that sounded really bad. Did you steal it?
No!
Sorry, no, you're right. Just have a nice day.
Yeah, thanks.
Mike, what do you do? I've never asked you.
If I tell you that, I'll have to kill you.
What, is it, like, secret?
No.
Hi, Bri.
Gone.
What's gone?
Can't paint.
Yes, you can, Brian. You're very good.
Mine's just blank, and I haven't painted anything in months. I don't know what's wrong.
Well, maybe you should try approaching the canvas in different ways.
I have. How do you tackle a creative block, Daisy?
Well, I'm actually very, very fortunate. I rarely suffer from writer's block. I'm extremely prolific.
You're very lucky.
Yeah, I know. Have you got any money, Brian? It's just I've got to go and sign on today and I can't afford the bus fare.
Can't you go to the bank?
Please, just a tenner. I haven't got a bank account. They closed it. I'm really, really worried. I haven't signed on for 3 months, and I didn't tell them I was going away.
I'm sure you'll be all right, Daisy. You know, they're reasonable people.
Please! Just a tenner!
Tim? Is everything all right?
Yes! Why?
No reason.
I've lost my job.
What? Why? Not Phantom Menace.
Better go.
All right, Brian. Good luck with your blockage. Oh, there's a letter came for you.
Thanks. Sorry about your job, Tim.
Yeah, I'm sorry about your uncle, Brian.
Come on, mate. It's not as if he hasn't fired you before, you know, and he's a reasonable bloke. I'm sure if you just went and talked to him, you could sort it out.
I don't think so, Daisy. He said he had somebody coming in for an interview this afternoon.
Well, one thing's for sure. There'll be no Tim Bisley.
Well, it all seems to be in order. When can he start?
Come on, Tim. There'll be other jobs. Anyway, what about your comic? You know, I'm sure the comic industry is desperately in need of a giant, you know, mutant bear with special claws. You just got to get out there.
Yeah, well, I'm scared.
Of what?
Nothing.
Come on. I was about to go and sign on. Why don't you come with me?
OK.
Why don't you lend me the bus fare?
OK.
Yeah. You have got a very special talent, Tim Bisley. And sooner or later, it's going to make you a lot of money.
Yeah, thanks, Daisy. I wish I had another special talent to fall back on.
Dear Brian, I hope this letter finds you well and that you're not finding being a lawyer too stressful. Sadly, I'm writing with bad news. Your Uncle Kevin died in his sleep last weekend whilst driving to Staines on the M4. We hope you can find time in your busy schedule to come to the funeral, which is next Thursday. Lots of love, Mum.
Frightened. What are you going to say?
I'm just going to tell him I was ill and start crying. Look, that's you. New claims.
Where?
There.
Oh, yeah, OK. Good luck.
Yeah, you too. Hello. I'm Dave.
Daisy Steiner. I had an appointment at 10:30. I'm late.
Daisy Steiner, you need to take an A, B form from the stand and then join the queue.
How long will I have to wait?
I'm sorry, I don't understand. Just fill out the form.
How long have you been unemployed, Mr. Beasley?
About an hour and a half.
Have you been looking for work?
No.
Why did you leave your last job?
I got fired.
Why?
A difference of opinion.
The Phantom Menace.
Yeah.
Didn't you like it?
No.
Well, leave this with me. I'll get you some money out in the next few days.
Hello.
Brian, it's me.
Hello, me.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
I miss you.
Miss me too.
Would you like to come out for drinks later?
Yes, please.
Then I could come and stay at yours. I don't have to work tomorrow. We could stay in bed all day. So don't forget to wash your sheets.
Right.
And your penis.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
No, this is the AB form. You need the AB form, capital B.
But what? I've been here for over an hour.
Just over there on the stand.
Is it?
Okay, you want to sign on again? Right, you last signed on 3 months ago. What have you been doing for the last 3 months?
I've been ill.
Do you have a doctor's note?
No, I lost it. Look, this shouldn't be a problem. I just want some money. You've always given me money before.
Sure you haven't been on holiday or something?
Me? God, no. I couldn't afford that. Not on my income.
So thank for Saigon, not now.
Doi con bet noi vie dolego angu.
You bastard!
What can I say? She liked me.
What am I going to do? I've got to pay the rent.
Can't you just write some articles?
It's not actually as easy as that, Tim. I can't just pluck another winter skincare do's and don'ts out of the air.
Why? Yeah, well, maybe poverty will inspire you. Look, it's not as bad as all that, all right? Mike's given us a few quid every week.
But what if he wants to move out?
Yeah, well, he doesn't at the moment, you know, he's happy. Besides, it's not as if he's going to get a better offer by the time we get back, is it? Eh?
Mike, do you mind if we...
What are you doing?
Well, Marsha has kindly offered me the position of lodger, which I have duly accepted.
But, Mike...
No. You've been kind enough to let me stay, but now you're back, Daisy. I think it's only right I should be moving on.
Yeah, but we like having you here, Mike.
It'll be fine, Tim. I'm only upstairs. We can see each other every day. We'll be able to legitimately use our walkie-talkies without having to go to the park.
Ready then, Mike?
I will be with you in 1 second, Mrs. Kane.
There he is, then, my new lodger. Just as well. Hardly ever see the other one.
Yeah. Brian's spending a lot of time with Twist. I mean, I hardly see her. I sometimes hear her. Yeah, he was up earlier on. I think he's having some kind of creative crisis.
Serves him right for getting his knackers in a twist. Come on then, Mike. I'm looking forward to having a big, strong bloke round the house.
Oh, who's that?
You, your pillock.
Oh, right.
He's funny, isn't he?
Any thoughts?
Well, I'm going to get some new batteries from a walkie-talkie.
Not about our situation. We're both unemployed. I'm getting no benefit. We need money. How else am I going to afford aspirational magazines?
Well, I'm going to get a job.
Why? You've just signed on. You don't have to.
I like working, Daisy, you know. It's the smell of the ink, you know, the taste of the biscuit. Giving the little ones advice on their latest purchase.
People like you make me sick!
Yeah, so do I. Love working. Yeah, I was a barmaid once and I loved it, you know. The hustle and bustle of a busy bar.
Can I get some service, please?
Oh, fuck you. What can I say? You know, we are good with people.
Absolutely.
And that's what writers do, isn't it? You know, they take unrelated jobs in order to make money and gain experience. Now, I temped in this office once, and then, you know, there were some great characters, you know, real fodder. There was this guy, Tony. Oh, what did he say? Anyway, that's what I'm going to do.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, everyone does things they don't want to do sometimes, you know. I mean, Mike isn't really doing what he wants to do, but he just makes the best of it.
Does he?
No! 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 No, look at me! No!
Well, I am going to go to one of those temping places and put my name down for a job.
That's the spirit, Daisy. New horizons. Pasture's green. Change.
And not the small kind.
Why is that funny?
I don't know.
You worked in a comic shop before?
Yeah, the Fantasy Bazaar.
Fantasy Bazaar? That's Bilbo Bagshot's shop, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why'd you leave?
It's a difference of opinion.
Phantom Menace?
Well, yeah, and I wanted to change.
Okay. When can you start?
I'm sorry?
When can you start?
So, what kind of work can you do? Sorry. What kind of work can you do?
Well, I'm creative. But, you know, I'm at home in the normal office environment. But equally comfortable, you know, in the hustle and bustle of an eatery.
So that's anything, then?
Yes, anything. Yeah, I'm desperate.
Everything all right?
Oh, yes, thank you, Mrs. K.
Well, give us a shout if you need anything.
Okay.
Anything at all?
Okay, then.
I like to think I'm an approachable landlady.
Okay, then.
That's great.
So anything you want, just ask.
Is there a key to this lock?
Hello, Brian.
Mum.
Aren't you going to invite me in?
A bit busy.
Doing what? Nice to see you've tied it up a bit.
Thanks.
Daisy was telling me you're feeling a little dry. Everything okay? Yeah.
Don't know, Marcia. Just can't seem to get inspired. You know, it used to come so easily. Thought I'd cracked it this morning. Got a letter saying Uncle Kevin had died. Next thing I knew, I was painting, couldn't stop. And then twist called and lost it. Just went.
You know what your problem is, Brian?
What?
You're happy. I think you'll find you dried up the minute you started seeing twit.
Do you think so?
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? You cannot have your cake and eat her, Brian. Contentment is the enemy of invention.
Oh, my God.
Funny, isn't it? You were so prolific when we was at him.
This is awful.
Isn't it? What a dilemma.
I can't believe this.
It's so depressing, Brian. You must be really worried.
Yeah.
Angst angst-ridden. Yes. Inconsolable.
Yes.
Right, I'm off. Mike's cooking beans, then we're going to polish his gums and watch the A-team. Bye. I love it when a plane comes together.
Hello, silent reading.
Yes, we do stock Jar Jar Binks merchandise. Yeah, we've got him in cuddly form, lunchbox, action figure and keyring. No problem. Bye-bye.
Well done, Tim. You've just taken your first step into a larger world.
All right, Derek.
Bilbo?
I was wondering if I could have a chat with Tim.
Certainly. I'll put some tea on. Want a cup, Tim?
Yes, please.
He's mount his collector's editions behind the counter in full view, not hide them away at the back of the shop. Man's insane.
What do you want to talk to me about, Bilbo?
So, how's it going?
Yes, all right.
What's Derek like as a boss?
He's okay. Don't really agree with his policy on vintage comic display.
Look, Tim, I'm sorry I sacked you, right? It was a mistake.
Oh, what, things not working out with the new guy?
You could say that.
Hawk the Slayer's rubbish.
I see.
Will he come back?
Well, I like it here, Bilbo. What makes you think I want to come back?
This.
Bilbo, this is Tim. Look, please, can I come back? I don't like it here.
You got that, did you?
Tim, I would have come in anyway. The place is just not the same without you there.
I'm already there.
What?
I mean, I'll come back.
Oh, yeah, you frightened me for a bit.
I'll have to give my notice here, though.
Well, can't he just get fired?
Derek? Babylon 5's a big pile of shit.
Get out!
Yay!
I got my job back.
Hey!
I got my own room.
Hey!
How's Brian doing?
He's standing in the garden with no clothes on.
Hey!
What about Daisy?
She got a job in a bookshop.
She'll be all right.
Yeah.
Hey!
Excuse me. Can you point me in the direction of personal growth?
Fuck you.
S'il vous plaît.